Blitzer sitting in for Larry tonight. Michael Moore is with us. He's the Oscar and Emmy Award-winning documentary director. Films include Capitalism, A Love Story, and Sicko. He's an activist, best-selling author, and good guest here on Larry King Live. Michael, thanks for joining us.
Hey, thanks for having me on, Wolf, and happy birthday to you.
Oh, thank you very much. Nice of you to know that.
Well, now it's all of the web universe knows
the whole world now knows.
We've been celebrating all day, and if I am correct, you're just 3 years away from being able to partake in that socialized medicine we have.
Let's hope it doesn't go forward. All right, let's talk a little bit about this medicine and healthcare reform.
I'm talking about Medicare.
Let's talk a little bit about what has now happened. History has happened. As you know, we spoke not that long ago. You didn't love this bill, to put it mildly, but you wanted everyone to vote for it. It is now about to become the law of the land with President Obama's signature tomorrow morning. It will be the law of the land. What do you think?
Well, I think great. As I said on your show last week, I wanted people to vote for this in Congress, but I'm saying that with many, many reservations. I believe this bill is two steps forward and one giant step backwards. The two steps forward are there's a number of really good things in this bill in terms of 6 months from now, insurance companies won't be able to deny children coverage because of a pre-existing condition. And by the way, insurance companies, if you just happen to be listening, why don't you just start tomorrow? Why would you deny a child health coverage because they had a pre-existing condition? I mean, seriously, that's it. How inhumane can you be? The other good thing about this bill is that kids will be able to stay on their parents' health plan, assuming the parents have one, until they're 26 years old. That's a really good thing.
There's other positive things that everyone seems to support. If you get really sick, there's not going to be a cap on how much the insurance companies can pay. They're going to have to pay whatever it costs to get you healthy.
Not exactly true, Wolf. There will be an annual cap for the next 4 years. So in other words,
but eventually, when the legislation fully takes effect.
Yes. Correct. In 2014, after another 30,000 or 40,000 people have died as a result of not being able to get the health care that they need, it will be the law of the land. So, way to go.
What don't you like about this bill?
The worst thing about the bill is that our health care system in this country remains in the hands of private profit-making insurance companies who stand between us and the doctors. These companies are still going to be calling the shots. They are still going to, this system will still be structured to pose the question every single day in every single waiting room, every single hospital room, what's in it for me, say the health insurance companies, where's the profit? Or how can we make sure that we don't lose too much money off this poor sick person?
But as you know, President Obama never
still going to be answered.
President Obama never wanted to remove the private health insurance companies. He always said from day one, that's when right, he was a candidate and since becoming president, that if you like the health insurance plan you have, you're happy with it, you're going to be able to keep it.
Right, which really, that attitude really feeds to one of the worst things about us as a people, which is, hey, If I'm doing okay, well, heck, then it's good enough for everybody else. You know, it's like, that's the wrong way. He positioned that the wrong way. By the way, just to be honest, when you say he ran as a candidate that way, actually when he first was running for Senate, he said that he thought a single payer system was the best system.
Right. He always said that if he had to create one from scratch, and this goes way back, he would have done that. But given the realities of the world today, he said that was a non-starter.
Way back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. If he could start from scratch, well, you know, here's the great thing about if you get elected president of the United States, leader of the free world, you actually can start things from scratch. You actually can actually walk in there and say, you know what, I think there's a better way to do this. Let's try that. Abe Lincoln did it. Franklin Roosevelt did it. John Kennedy did it. Quite a few people have come up with crazy ideas like, hey, in 9 years, we're going to have a man on the moon. It's like, and then they have the leadership to get everybody rallied around that and say, yeah, let's go for it.
He didn't say when he was a candidate for president, he supported the so-called single-payer system. And he even walked away from what a lot of liberals and progressives would have liked as that so-called public option. That's not included in this new law.
That's correct. So for everybody who's watching, please understand this. We do not have universal health care in this country tonight as a result of this bill. In fact, we do not have any real overhaul of our healthcare system. We had a profit-making system based on capitalist principles before this bill was passed, and we have the same thing now after that bill is passed.
Except for one thing, Michael, 32 million Americans who today don't have access to health insurance, they will have access to health insurance. There may be another 10 million who won't, but you have to admit over the next few years, bringing 32 million Americans into the health insurance system is a good thing.
Absolutely. But please remember the key word there, and you did quote them correctly. 32 million now more people will have access to health care, not health care. In other words, there'll be a system set up where a goodly number of them are going to have to write a check to those profit-making companies who must be just, you know, it's funny, all day today, Wolf, on the talk shows and on cable news and whatever, I haven't seen any of the CEOs from the health insurance companies on there talking about how horrible this bill is for them. Because ultimately it isn't. They're going to make billions more now because we've just mandated millions of more customers for them.
And if you watch
I just wanted to finish answering your point, which is, yes, so 32 million, that's good. 15 million still won't have that access. And so that means so many thousands of people are going to die each year. They've been given a death sentence, these 15 million that still aren't going to have it. And I just think as Americans, you know, when we decided to get rid of slavery, we didn't say, well, you know, we're going to free 32 million of the slaves, but 15 million of those slaves are still going to have to be in slavery. You know, we didn't say, well, we're going to give 32 million women the vote, but 15 million, you know. But Mike, you know, be happy about that. 32 million women are going to get the vote now. It's like, no, I wouldn't be happy about that if that was the case in 1920.
But you are happy that the president will sign this into law, because the alternative, you say, would have been a disaster. And we'll pick up that thought when we continue Larry King Live. We'll be right back.